Hi, I'm Ramgopal from presentationprocess.com. In this video, you will learn how to create a stunning YouTube intro using PowerPoint animation. The beautiful and stunning YouTube intro you will learn to create today looks like this. On a click, yeah, isn't it awesome? I'm going to show you how to create this awesome looking PowerPoint intro from scratch. So here I am on a new slide, and the first thing I'm going to do is to go to Auto Shapes menu, pick up this rectangle tool, and I'm going to draw a small square. Let us say the height and width of the square is 2 inches each. So let us go here and say 2 and 2. This is the format tab in PowerPoint ribbon, and we are playing in the size group here. So once this is done, let us go to shape outline and say no outline, go to shape fill, choose a color. I'm going to choose this teal color. Now this is beautiful. Now I'm going to go to home, arrange and align and say align center. So compared to the slide, this is in the center. Then arrange, align, align middle. So it is exactly in the middle. Now we are going to add our first animation to this one. So I'm going to select this, go to the animations tab in PowerPoint ribbon, open this up and go to more entrance effects. And I'm going to choose under moderate the animation called basic zoom. And I'm going to say, okay. Now the way it works, if I go to the slideshow mode, this is how it works. Now I don't want it to come from in to out. We are going to have out to in. So that is how it is going to be. Beautiful. Now I'm going to add another animation to the same object. So let us go to animation pane, and you can see whatever that I'm going to do here. So let us select the same thing and add animation. And this time I'm going to say spin. And this is going to happen in 0.5 seconds. And I am working with the timing group here. So duration is 0.5 seconds and it's going to happen with previous. So when we play from this, this is how it enters. Excellent, isn't it? Now let us make a copy of the shape by pressing Ctrl D. And I don't want these animations associated with it. So I'm going to delete them. And this copy, I'm going to place right on top of the previous one, and I'm going to stretch this so that it touches the left side and then to the right side. So what it means is the previous one is going to come in and then it is going to extend to this. So this is what is the next step. So this is going to enter by way of split, and it is going to enter vertical out, and this is going to happen after previous. So the first square entered with a basic zoom and spin and then came into the center. After that, this is going to split out. So the way it plays is like that. Awesome, isn't it? Now the next step is to have these two lines to go from the center out. Now I'm going to go to home. And let us go to the rectangles tool and let us draw a simple rectangular bar that touches from left to right, shape outline, no outline. And let us choose maybe some this kind of a golden color to this one. Yeah, that looks beautiful. And let us have a copy of this. I'm going to hold the control button down as I paste this on the other side. So holding the control button down ensures that you make a copy of this and then you can place it wherever you want. So we've got these two. Now, how are we going to have this enter? The first thing is I'm going to select both of them and I'm going to add the animation called appear. So this is going to appear. Both these things are going to appear after previous. Then we are going to have this appear in the center and then move out. So that is what is the point. So the way we are going to do this is I'm going to select this and then I'm going to add animation. Remember, if you go here and add an animation, it will replace the existing animation. We don't want that. We want to have multiple animations on the same object. So we are going to add animation to this one. And the animation that I'm going to go for is maybe we can go down here, and it is the lines animation. So that is the animation, and let us have this come somewhere till the center. So that is what is the animation going to be. Now we want this line to appear in the center and then go out. So what we need to do is to go to Effect Options and then go to this option called Reverse Path Direction. So that is how it goes out. Beautiful, isn't it? Now let us do the same thing for this one. So we've got this. Go to Add Animation, go down and say Lines, and you can see that this is how it goes by default. We are going to hold the red circle, which denotes the end point here, and then go and place it in the center. And we do the same thing. Go to Effect Options and Reverse Path Direction. Yeah, that is beautiful. And let us have these two happen for just 0.5 seconds. And they are going to happen. The first one is going to happen after previous, and the second one is going to happen with previous. Now, when that happens, you can see the way it plays so far now. It enters, and that is how it is. Did you see that? Now, let me give you a quick overview of what we have done. First, a square enters the scene with a basic zoom while spinning, and then this rectangle splits out. And then we have these two rectangles. So what's happening here for one rectangle is it is appearing. After it appears, it moves from here to here. So that is what is happening. So it appears and then moves from here to here, and it is happening in both directions. And that is the reason why these two lines are appearing in the center and they are moving out. And that is what we have done so far. Now the next thing is we are going to have a line drawn here on both sides. So let us go to Home, go to Auto Shapes menu, pick up the line tool. So we have this simple line tool here. Hold the shift button down as you draw a perfectly horizontal line. Go to Shape Outline and say White Outline, and then increase the weight of this, say to 4.5 points, maybe 3 points is good enough. And let us make a copy of this by holding the Control button down as we move this to the new location. Excellent. Now, what we're going to do is, we are going to have this one exit. So we are going to go to Animations and say Add Animation. Since we already got so many animations on this, we don't want to replace any of those. So that is the reason why I went to Add Animation. And here we are going to have a wipe animation. So that's a very important one, wipe exit animation. So that is how it wipes. But we want it to wipe from right. So this is how it goes away. And as it goes like that, we want this line to go from left to right. So let us add wipe animation and left to right. So this is how it is going to be. And this is going to be with previous. And the previous exit is going to happen after previous. So these rectangles come and go to the side, and after that this goes away and this line comes in, and we're going to do the same thing for this as well. So select this, add animation, and go to wipe exit animation, but this time let us wipe this out from left. So let us go here, and at the same time this line needs to wipe from right, we say with previous. So this is going to happen after previous. Okay, so let us play from here where these lines appear, go here and then go away, and let us see how it works. So play from this. Can you see? It has gone out and then it exited. Now is the time to add one other layer of animation. We want to have two shapes going out from here and here. So let us pick up this shape. I just picked the shape from one of the public domain sites. So let us copy this and go to the new place. I don't want any animation previously associated with it. So I'm going to select this and press delete so we can add the animation from the beginning. So now this is the picture and you can see that there is no animation associated with it. Now I'm going to place this here. You can use any other shape instead of this kind of a shape. You can use a simple circle if you want to. You can have a diamond shape if you want to. It is completely up to you. Now I have got this, so that is the reason why I'm using it. So I'm going to have this right click and send to back. And then I want to make a copy of this by pressing Ctrl D. And then I am going to go to a home, arrange, rotate and say flip vertical so that it can be placed here, and right click and send to back. So this looks beautiful. Now the thing is, even if you have it in the regular normal mode, your design should look attractive. And that is the reason why I have done some work around, like having reverse path direction and all that stuff. So here we have got these two shapes. So let us have them peek out. So I'm going to select this, go to animation, and then go to more entrance effects, and let us have them peek in. So the peek in option is available here. It is under basic, so let us have peek in. Yeah, that is excellent. And we are going to say okay. And this one has to peek in the same way. So more entrance effects, basic, peek in, and say okay. But this time it is going to peek in from top. And the first peek in is going to happen after previous, and the next one is going to happen with previous, so that at the same time both of them peek in from this particular rectangle. So that is the whole idea. Now let us play this from somewhere till here, and then let us play from. So that is how it is, and both of them are peeking out. Excellent. Now we need to add two more things. What we want to have in the center, and then what we want to have as a byline. So I'm going to choose the program that we have, PowerPoint program that we have, called Ramgopal's PowerPoint Mastery Program. And I'm going to select this text. I'm going to press Ctrl C, go to the new slide, and then paste it here. And we don't want any animation associated with them, so I'm going to delete that. And this one I'm going to place right in the center. And this one I'm going to have touching like this. Now the animation that I'm going to add for this one is a very simple fade animation, and this has to happen after previous. And this one will be a float-in animation, and this needs to happen at 0.5 seconds. This is the duration for 0.5 seconds, and it is going to happen after previous, and that is it. Now we've got a whole bunch of animations done. To give you a quick rundown, there is a square that enters with basic zoom while spinning, and then this one splits out, and then we have these two lines appear, and then after they appear, they move from the center to out, and the same thing happens to both. And then this one wipes out while this line wipes in, and the same thing is going to happen to this one as well. So this wipes out from left, and then this wipes in from right. And then we have these two elements peeking in from behind this particular shape, and then we have this fading in, and this one floats in from the bottom. So let us see the entire thing happening in sequence. Go to slideshow, on a click the show begins. Now talk about that. Isn't it beautiful? So that is how you create this beautiful and elegant looking intro. You can use this to introduce your channel. You can write your channel name here, and you can write your own name here. If you don't want this byline, you can of course remove this. If you want to have this byline, then you can use this to introduce your presentation. You can have your presentation title here, and then you can have your byline here. Now that is when your presentation really captures your audience's attention. Now I'm going to show you some intro title templates taken from our comprehensive all-in-one PowerPoint bundle. In case you don't know, this bundle is a collection of more than 4,020 premium PowerPoint templates that help you convert any text-based slides into clear and compelling visual slides in a matter of minutes. If you are a business professional, then this is the template bundle you want to go for. Let me show you some interesting animated intro templates taken from this bundle. The first one is very similar to the one that I showed you, and this is how it looks. So this is what I recreated for you. So this is the title of the presentation, and this is the name of the presenter. Now let me show you some interesting alternatives. Now this one introduces the title and the subtitle. Can you see some very interesting flourishes there? Observe the animation in the next one. Awesome, isn't it? Now let us show the next one. Beautiful. Next one. Next one. So as you can see here, there are quite a few very interesting and exciting animated intro titles available as part of comprehensive all-in-one PowerPoint bundle. The bundle that I showed you is a treasure house of any kind of template you can imagine. And if you were to create all these on your own, you really have to spend a lot of time. And that is the reason why it is such a smart thing to go for comprehensive all-in-one PowerPoint bundle. Now, if you're someone who prefers to learn things on your own, then you can always go to our Ramgopal's PowerPoint Mastery Program. This is arguably the most comprehensive and creative PowerPoint training program online. Now, what I had shown you was just one example of how to use animation powerfully. Now, inside this program, I have 110 video tutorials, step-by-step video tutorials on the topic of PowerPoint animation alone. Now, that tells you the kind of vastness and comprehensiveness of the curriculum inside this program. If you are someone who uses PowerPoint for your work, then this is a program that you can't live without. So please go to presentationprocess.com and check out for Ramgopal's PowerPoint Mastery Program. I'll also leave a link to this program in the description box below this video. You can click on the link and know more about this program. You have a beautiful video which runs for almost 40 minutes that gives you everything that is included in this program. So you can check out the complete details of this program and make your decision. And if you want to get a quick glimpse of the true power of PowerPoint, then I highly recommend you join our free email course called 16 Snackable PowerPoint Tricks. This email course offers 16 super short emails, with each email giving you a 30-second PowerPoint hack. You can learn and implement the hack in 30 seconds flat. You'll be able to join this course by clicking on the link here. So please click on the link and join the course, and I will see you inside.